what is the gospel? And one of the terrible things that I found out is that so many don't really know what the gospel is. How can you believe something you don't understand? How can you believe it? You don't understand it. You have to understand it first. In Proverbs chapter 4, in verse number 7, the Bible tells us wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom. Tell somebody, wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom. He didn't say money is the principal thing. Wisdom is the principal thing. So he says, therefore, get wisdom. Then he says, and with all thy getting, get understanding. Understanding. How important is understanding? You know, Jesus told a parable of the man, the sower, that went forth to sow. And he says, as he sowed, some seeds fell by the wayside, and the birds of the air came and picked them up. In his interpretation, Jesus said, the seeds that fell by the wayside are those who hear the word of God and don't understand it. Then he said, then Satan comes immediately, not later. Satan comes immediately and steals away, takes away the seeds. And here's something very important. He says, the seeds that were sown in their hearts, meaning that the word actually got into their hearts, but they didn't understand it. So the devil took it away from them. You have to understand the message, the gospel. So number one is to understand it. You got to understand it. Understand the gospel. If you understand the gospel, you will never need another fire. You know, as we minister to people from all over the world, we find so many who are looking for second fire, third fire, second anointing, third anointing, fourth anointing, double anointing, triple anointing. You know, they're looking for all of these things. And it's because they don't understand the scriptures. They don't. You can tell from the songs they sing. You can tell. There's one I sang for a long time too. And one day I was singing it again. The Lord said, stop it. And I said, what's wrong with it? He said, listen to yourself. I can sing it to you. Some of you notice it's sung in churches. It'll tell you why the churches are filled with babes. Babes, even the pulpit. There's a lot of babes. But you see, Jesus is coming for a church without spot, without wrinkle, without blemish or any such thing. He's coming for a grown church. Hallelujah.